This is, you can't even enjoy the day on a bike ride. It smells so bad.
Red tide taking a toll in Collier County. Stinky dead fish are clogging up canals behind multi-million dollar homes in North Naples. Our crews found tons of dead fish in the waterway near Gulf Shore Drive and Channel Drive.
NBC2's Alexis Santos joins us live from that area to explain who is in charge of cleaning it up.
Well, the latest sampling event found high levels of red tide out in the Gulf off Vanderbilt Beach and Seagate Beach. But if you take a look here, there are plenty of dead fish washing up in waterways like this one, canals behind people's homes, and we've even spotted maggots crawling around on some of the dead fish.
It's just like a dirty stench.
The red tide persists in Collier County.
Today, it's strong in particular. It's a gross scene.
Dead fish gathering in bunches in canals along Gulf Shore Drive in North Naples.
It's horrible. It's so sad.
Mm-hmm.
I know there's a lot of fish in the sea, but that's a lot of fish.
Sure.
A lot of dead fish.
Bill Connor came to Collier County today from Lee County to escape the worst of it. But that didn't go so well.
I wanted to get away from the smell over on Fort Myers Beach, so I came down here for a bike ride, and it's no better. You can't even enjoy the day on a bike ride. It smells so bad.
Over the weekend, people living on the Vanderbilt Lagoon snapped these photos of countless fish floating in the water. Jackie Chavari is new to the area and has several small children and a newborn.
For a little guy and little kids, it's a lot to take in, to breathe in.
People are getting fed up.
Not a good smell, not good to look at. It's not enjoyable. You can't live like this.
And hoping the red tide clears sooner rather than later.
It is disappointing. Hoping it clears itself up quickly and moves on, and we don't see it again for a while.
A spokesman for Collier County tells me that they clean up the fish that wash up on the beaches, but not the fish that are in waterways like this one. At this point, they're waiting on the tides and weather patterns to move these fish out of this area. Reporting live in Collier County, Alexis Santos, NBC2.